First of all, I want to thank Dr. Osama and Dr. Ahmed Al-Gurani for inviting me for this talk. In order to give an idea about ozone therapy in general, I'm point out that if it could have be a role in urogenital disease. we will talk about what is ozone therapy, you know, history of ozone therapy, mechanism of action, methods of administration of ozone therapy. Then we will know if we could have a role in as a complementary role in urogenital disease, and show why ozone therapy is not present in the guidelines, and so explain how could be the advantage of having ozone therapy in urogenital diseases and conclusion. Actually, ozone is three atoms oxygen. Oxygen formed by three atoms that may be formed by the ultraviolet rays or high voltage. History, ozone therapy is not a new recent modality. It's been used since the World War II to treat wounds, infections, gangrene, and poisoning gas. Actually, ozone has so many benefits as an antioxidant, improving circulation, relieving pain, increasing metabolism, anti-inflammatory, anti-aging effect with cellular regeneration. When we used to see these effects and the benefits of ozone therapy, and we have been always asked why, we long ago we don't have an explanation for this. But actually now there is a lot of studies done on the basal and the molecular levels that shows that ozone therapy could have a role based on the molecular biology and the cytokines. And starting from activation of the genes and the molecular factors to mitochondrial function activation, we could reach an antioxidant effect that could be helpful in many clinical improvement in systemic associated disease. Method of administration of ozone therapy, we have major autohemotherapy, that's extracorporeal blood or minor autohemotherapy, insufflation of medical ozone with a rectal, vaginal, or urinary bladder or ear. This is a set used for major autohemotherapy. When we take blood from the patient and mix it with ozone, and then re-infuse it back to the patient. And this is the ozone generators used for preparation of ozone. And there is the rectal insufflation for ozone therapy that could be done by this set or by syringes. We can do local application for ozone for, as ozone bag for wounds or ozone cups for ulcers. Ozone also could be injected in subcutaneous tissue and local wound injection. Also, the local application for ozone, ozonated olive oil, or ozonated distilled water that could be used in wounds. And we have also ozone sauna for transcutaneous ozone absorption. And we have now known the fact that the molecular basis of action of ozone on biological level, how its effect could be done. So we will point to some urogenital diseases. Here we can see that ozone therapy acting as anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, and vasodilator effect, affecting mainly nitric oxide, which play a very important role in vasodilation, and decreasing apoptosis and fibrosis. For renal disease that are, renal pathologies are public, global, affecting quality of life, expensive for the patient or the government, or highly prevalent. a lot of research done now, either experimental or human studies. Most of these studies showed in experimental and laboratory and the histopathological level, the anti-inflammatory, antioxidant effect of ozone, especially the vasodilator effect of increased nitric oxide and its producing enzymes, and the role of ozone therapy in decreasing what is called the ischemic reperfusion injury, which is brought by biomolecular and histopathological studies, decreasing apoptosis and decreasing fibrosis. In all the study, when we review the literature, there is no randomized controlled trials or meta analysis for ozone therapy that could allow ozone therapy to be present in the guidelines. But all the meta-analysis and reviews of literature mentioned that the safety and the effectiveness of ozone therapy is high and is realized, so it can be used with safety. So if someone wanted to use ozone therapy, he must be assured of the safety. So safety and effectiveness of ozone therapy is highly mentioned. We also must mention that ozone therapy is not the main line of treatment at any cases or at any diseases. It is a complementary tool that we can use in many diseases or many specialties, but it's not the main line of treatment. So in cases done for 50 cancer patients, there was on fatigue, ozone therapy helped relief of fatigue. Experimental study was done for cryptorchidism. Anti-stocular torsion showed by histopathological study decreased in the anti-oxidative stress compared to other antioxidants like melanin. Also, the effect of ozone therapy when there is in complex patients like multi-organs. So medical ozone therapy can have increased renal blood flow even in patients with chronic severe hepatitis. Installation, intravesical ozone in water installation have been used in the progressive radiation induced hematuria. Also, microcirculation and structural organization of the bladder mucosa in chronic cystitis have been treated with ozone by parenteral ozone therapy, where there is decreased inflammation of the bladder mucosa. Complex conservative therapy of chronic bacterial prostatitis, which is a common case faced by urologists and urosurgery. Also, so that in a study on 58 patients, rectal ozone supplemented other treatments with positive results. Also, there was a trial about intraprostatic ozone therapy injection locally on 30 patients when there was decrease in the mean prostatic volume and decrease in the post voiding volume. When we talk about the pathology of diabetes, it's mainly through formation of advanced glycation in the products that lead to the vasculopathy that affects all the blood vessels. Ozone had shown a good effect in secretion of vasodilators, especially nitric oxides. This is an example from another case for diabetic foot that here, besides the healing of the wound, we can see how the vascularity, the peripheral circulation, the color of the leg have been changed. by ozone therapy. This is also another patient with peripheral ischemia and cardiac patient with low ejection fraction. He could not be a candidate for vascular surgery. We used also only ozone therapy when we, after rectal ozone therapy, have regained peripheral circulation. We have been using ozone therapy for many cases with cardiomyopathy, having low ejection fraction, and the results was always helpful. A patient may rise from ejection fraction 35 up to 40 or 45. Improvement in the 6-minute walk distance and improvement in the walking distance. When we come to erectile dysfunction, the problem is increasing. Nearly 322 million expected to be present by 2025, with a lot of risk factors and complex cases, which is present with other diseases. Global trends in prevalence and treatment and cost of benign prostatic prosthesis, I found it well reviewed literature. The inclusive cost of the surgery increased 4 times in the past 3 decades, and the total surgical cost also. And innovative trends in perspective for erectile dysfunction treatment in a systemic review concluded that the current treatment of erectile dysfunction is still far from ideal, and they expected to see new drugs and technologies that may revolutionize erectile dysfunction treatment, especially in complex cases. PRP have been used in different specialties. In fact, ozonated PRP lead to increase in the growth factor more than 4 to 6 times. Why ozone therapy is not present in the guidelines so far? Because there is no randomized controlled trials or meta-analysis present in the literature. Anyhow, we can conclude that ozone therapy could be included as complementary therapy in neurogenital diseases. Ozone therapy is safe, effective, flexible, and cheap modality of therapy. You can use it without waiting for randomized controlled trials or the guidelines as a complementary therapy, as its effects have been beneficially proved by systemic local effects and by unique pharmacophysiological effects. Ozone therapy could be used with other modalities, so it is not whether to choose ozone therapy or other modalities. It can be used as a complementary therapy in most of the modalities. And finally, more researches are needed to put ozone therapy into guidelines, though positive results encourage its use. Thank you.